Okay, I'm going to take a drawing, a paper all the way from the drawing forward, because I want to show you, we're looking at the whole idea of animal anatomy, and I want to show you how I would tackle the drawing, and how I would just figure out the whole thing. So there's a couple ways you could do this. I always use the grid, good way to get your proportions correct when you're painting or drawing. And there's two ways you could do it. One, you just lay the grid over top like those little programs do for you. And I've got an example of that in the PowerPoint. But the other thing to do is I like to sit down and look at proportions. So with this horse, what I did is I sat down and said, okay, what's the distance from there to there? Oops, now it's gonna be a problem for me. What's the distance from there to there, and how's that relate to anything else? And discovered that it's basically a square. That bulk of his body is a square. So I drew a square, divided it in quarters. And then I started looking at other relationships and realized that this distance is the same as that distance right out to his nose. So I dropped extended another rectangle out that way that's the same width as this. And now there's his head, fits perfectly inside that. And then I took this square, dropped it down below just to see where everything was in relationship to the square. And there's my grid. So to fit it on my page, I'm looking at my page and asking myself, where do I want the horse to fit? How close to the edges? And I'm going to use a darker pencil than I have to draw it with. Somebody asked me the other day which pencil I use, and I actually prefer to use 2H. It erases well. You never have any problems with it. So I'm going to draw with an HB for your sake so you can see my lines better. I hope that shows okay. I'll just check here and see. Yeah, that looks like it'll work. So if I'm going to make my horse that wide, that tells me a whole bunch of stuff. I'm going to take it and divide it into three. So I've got these three grids coming this way. And using my little ruler here, I can figure out where is it going to fit on here. So actually, it's going to be a square this way. So if I look at it that way, I can fit the horse kind of in that thing right there. So I'll do a couple of these. I'm going to draw the grid in. So there's my grid. You can see the horse doesn't fit in my format really well. You hook them up a little bit above here. And I can extend those legs down a little bit. So hopefully it won't be too bad. So you can see I've got some major intersections right here. There's where that neck goes past. Over here is where the other neck comes down. This comes right up to the edge. Comes right back in like this. And I've got a leg coming down this way. In here, I've got a jaw. And down here, I've got his nose, which is going kind of bark it in like a square, looking back. This is a little lower than that. This goes up, and let's see, that eye's going to be about it right there. And this This white thing at Chimpanos establishes a lot of perspective to everything. I'm just doing this in kind of quickly so I can just get things. This is about halfway up. Now there's a big muscle coming up through here. It comes up. Now let's put that line in there. Comes right below that line. Talked about this in class, but a hip on an animal often goes like that. It's roughly 45 and down. So I'm going to go 45 right there. And then it rounds off and comes down. There's that big belly that we'll talk about in class. It comes all the way down here. That's put in the middle. Right in there are these two muscle masses. That's over a bit. Is this? Is that leg? So in here, this one's. Now this beautifully comes right up into there. I'm purposely drawing these rounds so that I catch the roundness of them. Same thing with this cheek in here. And these knees, and come over just a little bit. That's a little bit over from that grid line. I'm getting detailed too fast. I need to finish walking out the head first. So if this is, let's see, 3 across, it would be 5. 23. Let's get us some of the back to the 3. I see them 3 times. It's not right. I got that wrong. I'm off. I should come out of here. Change pencil so skin dull. So using the grid, there's what I've done. See, without the grid, I would have ended up making this all bigger in here just because I would have thought that's what it looked like. I am going to just expand it beyond that grid just a touch. I'm just going to do that. All right, so there's my horse. Head may be a little bit too big, but no, actually, no, that's right. Yeah, I would have drawn the proportions all wrong. So now that I've got a horse in place, I'm going to do this. I'm going to establish my vertical line so I don't draw the horse crooked. And now I can determine where I want you to fit on the page, because it just gives a little bit more sentiment. I'm going to pull over this a little bit, make sure this line is still straight. And I think I'm okay here, so I'm going to let this drip. So I think we're good. ability vanishes the tracing papers, I can make all kinds of changes before I get to the waterfront and take the bay on. So now that I've tried to build this painting, this drawing, on looking for muscles. I watched these muscles in here and here, those horses, knobby knees. Make his legs a little bigger. And in here, there's some muscle groups going on that. So there's my. There's my rough line of my horse. So now I'm going to trace it onto my watercolor paper. If that should come down just a little bit, I'm going to do that just a little bit. Thank you very much. Like that. Okay, so there's an example how I would. I hope I've shown that effectively. What I was trying to do was, like, I see looking for these muscle groups so that I capture the feeling of the reality of where his muscles are going. And I find that some key lines would be the hip, the stomach, and these muscles in the legs. They really make and break the neck of your animal. Okay. Carbon paper out. And I will do a quick face job. Most of this. I use this pencil simply because when I drafted years ago, that's the kind of pencil I used. And it's just familiar in my hand. There's no other reason I'm not using it. Is that 45 degree? There's some muscle groups here on visual capture. Hey, sure. See what I've got. Now that muscle there is a common muscle in any of these large animals. Got that job on. Okay, so there's my outline of my hunch now that I need to do. I'm going to go back to this. Picture, what I need to do is I want to do the background first or. I mentioned last week that I now start drawing in color areas, or maybe color, it's tonal areas. And I start by marking where are my whites, where I want to remain white. Question is whether I will mask these or paint around them. Not sure yet. So there's white. There's actually a little bit of yellow there, but I'm going to do the white. There is a little bit of light along that thing. And this is white. Nose piece is white and turns to pink. So I'll do a lot of refining of that drawing. As we go here, we've just got the major masses in place. Okay, what should we do with that background? Yeah, I think I'm going to do is I'm going to stop the video for a minute. I'm going to mask the top half of the horse so that I can run water down and not get it onto the main body. These I don't care about so much because I want them to just kind of drift into the mix. So I'm going to do that. Be right back. Okay, of course, because I stopped and paused the tape, you don't know I've been gone for a couple hours here. I'm going through a massive argument with myself, a number of arguments. And I'll tell you a quick story. When I was a student teaching in Utah, in the high school, I managed to get in with the two best teachers in the state. They had one teacher of the year for 5 years in a row. They had a combined program. And one of the teachers' name was Al Davis. He was a ski instructor on the weekends up at Snowbird. His hero was an older man by the name of Junior Benuse. And one Monday morning, Al came into class and he was so, so pumped. And he said, "I have to tell you guys about my weekend." They'd had the those downhill races, the ones where they go 200 miles an hour down the hill, and they had just finished and hadn't taken down all the standards yet. And so it was the end of the day, and Al and Junior were going for Junior Benuse were going for this run down the hill. Junior's like 65, Al's 55, and they get to the top and they're looking down the hill at this race course, and Junior says, "Al, let's do it." And Al's going, "No, I don't think so." And Junior Benuse says, "Al, don't be a yabut." And then Junior took off down the hill. And under enormous peer pressure from his hero, Al felt the need to go and do the same thing. So he went over the edge and went down the hill and said it was one of the most exhilarating moments of his entire life. It was so fun just to let the skis go and race down his hill. But that became the phrase, "Don't be a yabut." So I've been yabutting for the last hour and a half here because, first of all, I knew I should do a colored sketch. But I kept telling myself, no, a waste of time, just get at it. So I said, no, I know it's the right thing to do. I have to do it. So I've been in the last hour and a half just fiddling around with this. A couple of quick little sketches. This is what I'm prone to do, more realistic in its approach. But as I thought about it, I thought, well, I'm going to do a second one because I need to have an alternate idea. So I just started playing with this. The horse is really poorly done, but it's just this idea. I've been hanging around Steve Finnemore too much and getting inspired by him. So so I thought, oh, what the heck? I may just get a little silly here and see what I can accomplish. So there's a couple of things I want to make sure I show you that I do so that what we're doing makes some sense. I think I need to get another book so I can raise this up a little higher so I've got more gravity working. But let me do that real quick and grab it. Kidnapped and Tom Sawyer. Can't go wrong with those. Grandson said he just finished reading those. So they're great. So I want what's the runaway happening down below here? I've masked this top half of the horse, which is it can create its own problems because I don't want to end it with a line right there. So I've got to be very careful. So I'm going to start with some background colors. I need a bigger brush. bigger area, bigger rush. It's the rules. Remember it. You have to just fall down there like that. I like that. I don't think I want to do much more. So let's get rid of it a little bit. Walk it away. Those nice marks happening there, so let those stay. I don't care for this, the way this line is coming down there, so let's just pull a little bit of that water out of there. I love that, that's awesome. Ooh, some carbazole violet. Some Now, let's bring a straw down and let left upstairs. I'm just going to do a little bit of this. Just a little bit. Just a little bit, because I'm scared. I want a little bit too much. I want a little bit less in here. Put a little bit of water out of there. Throw some more blue in them instead. I'll take some neutral tint just to some of those darks to get dark. I want it a little bit darker back in here. And it's a bit misted. Watch this edge right here. It's going to get ugly if I'm not careful. Clean brush, clean water. Get our fingers on it. All right. Oops, that's not too. okay. That's not terribly dramatic, but for me, that's a big deal. That's not what I would normally do. This is nice. Like that. Okay. Oh, first round of the experiment. Not too bad. I'm tempted to put a second layer. Just, you know, one of those cuz things. I'm just looking to see where the my darks are. Lift a little bit on this side. Because that it's gonna be dark, but this is gonna be light here, so I can darken up in there a little bit. Down here, so Okay, so I'll go up in there. Over in here, it'd be okay to go a little darker. So there's some balance to what's going on the other side. That's not a good one right there because it interferes with. So there's a bit of a balance thing now with some darks happening on both sides. A little bit more real dark in there. So there's a bit of a flow. So those darks coming through there. That fade a bit. If it's going to be dark, I want to start right up against it. Otherwise, those little spots will show and you wonder why they're there. I'm going to have to magic eraser some of that right out of there. But I like those lines. I like, I'm happy. I'm gonna put a little bit of splatter up there. Just a little. A little bit of texture in behind the horse there. Just a little bit, come on, where his eye is. Hey, that's what I want to do. Move a bit of the screen just so I have a better feel for the color. I'm not up and down. And there'll be some more stuff happening down here, so I won't uncover it yet. But hopefully, I like that. Great relief, he cried. Okay, a little repair work here first of all. There's a little bit of kitchen cleaner thing. Magic erasers, it's called. Get rid of that line. It's going to be dark, so it won't cause too much trouble. And I want to lift some paint up from around these ears, because they're going to be quite dark. So we'll just lift some of this out of there. So I'm thinking in terms of light against dark, dark against light. This is going to be white, so there is no problem. These will be dark, so I want a lighter sense of behind them. White along here. right up in here, I need to soften that edge there so I can As you all know, this is the challenge of masking. Oops. Oh. Right. It's all my dark colors. I need to fill this spot in here. Make a mess. A little bit of purple in it, just a touch. A little touch. one spot here where the residue is. Tends to race off the spine. Okay, now what I do next is what I was talking about last week in class, where before I tackle a horse, my next thing is the Sherman key. What's my lightest? My lightest is white. What's going to stay white? I want this along here, stay white, down into there. There's kind of a white spot right down in here. The tail I'll leave alone. There is a light spot along the edge, but it's not white. It's just a lighter color. And here, these stay white up there. White paint is going to help fix that problem up there. These stay white. This stays, actually, be quite accurate. There's just a touch of blue in there. And there is a little, there's a light spot right there on his eyelid, but it's not white. So let's go here. We'll go white here. It actually goes pink there and with a really pretty blue liner. And then it gets up here, it gets into a brown liner. So it says white there, white up here. I've gone a little too far up there. I'm going to cut that back just a little bit. This eyebrow, there's a light spot, but that again is not white, but it is an important spot. And then the corner of his eye, but it's not white. There's just a little bit of white right here where his ear actually does this. Now there is a spot right along here. There's you can see the sunlight coming through the fuzz on the end of his ear. So I'm just going to lift a little bit of color in there so it's not just a straight line. And we can try to create the fuzz later. So then my white spots are here. White, 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 white. And the tail, of course, we're going to leave that till the end. Now, my dad would call it $1 million question. I thought I was standing with the horse. I'm going to stick with this. There. Sure. These are just a couple of, oh, there's, look at here, right here, there's some white spots. Oh, oh, oh. We'll leave that white in there. She's just a little bit, kind of, yeah. Yeah, almost a step. And actually, some white trim right there on his chin. So I could, I could mask those, but I don't want harsh lines. So I'm not going to. I'm going to try to look around it. And I see that. Well, I've got harsh lines around here. We'll do something with the. Just look at the. Put it on the end of his nose, all that hair. Cool. All right. So that actually, I'm going to take a real light blue. Better clean up my tree here. Cobalt, and I oops see, these are just not quite actually white. There's even a little bit of blue coming through there, a little bit down here. Soften those edges. Same here. I'll leave those other white right there. Okay, now I've identified where the whites go. So now my question is, am I going to check it out and just stick with what's on the photo reference, or do I play around with this a little bit? Oh, goodness. Well, we're going to do the light first. So here we go. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. Stupid is, stupid does. It all adds up to the same. Here it goes. I'm going to throw in some of these yellow, oops, some of these hand colors as well, because it's just a little bit yellow. Bunch of yellow stuff going on there. Chicken, you big chicken. This is all dark in here, so it doesn't matter. Just want the water to run, so when it hits there, just let it run. Oops, there was a spot I was trying to preserve and I just wiped it. My green horse. Now I'm going to start knocking in some of the color when it's wet. I'm following some of these. muscle lines. Can be a dark spot in there. If I don't get these double lines built up where this crosses over, because then it just gets ugly. Looks like a cartoon after a while. So nice and wet. Ooh, look at that color. Here, it's going to darken up significantly in that belly. I can pull the purple into it. I'm trying to pull yellow out of it. A bit more orange up here in the face. He's got some nice orange stuff here. And we're down here. Like this sound. Sloppy coming down there like that. Look at the sloppiness. Let's put a little bit of color into that leg. You see, it'll be really fluffy. Okay, so that's more or less layer one. Green, that, yeah, that green wasn't a bad idea. Just afraid it was going to be. Now, before I go further, I'm going to draw in some of these things that I want to preserve in this color. So I'm going to go around some of these. This is, yeah, that's a good line in there. Oh, look at this one right here. Need a few more Let's go over here. Okay, so this in here, this in here. It's a little line there, right over here, there's a little line. So now it's getting finicky. Nothing in here that I need to be preserving yet. There's, let's see, this is this line that comes down here. Yeah, so I need. Neck, and this is coming in here, and there's going to be underneath that belly. Look at that, there's a nice line to preserve in here. See, there's this mane that comes down here. So there's actually kind of a this. So I'm identifying places I don't want to cut my brush. Inevitably, I'm going to make big mistakes and get into stuff I shouldn't be. But I've got a guideline. Let's hope it works. Hang on to your hats. I want this a little darker, so I'm going to use some burnt sienna along with this little bit of oranges and use it like so much. And I'm going to venture into a little bit of carbazole violet on the edge because I discovered a neat kind of cool color together. It's probably a little too dark. I actually want some blue in there. No, some purple. I want some purple in there with a bit of blue. It's a nice defined little edge there. I'm gonna come in here with a few. It's a bit brown, isn't it? It's not what I was aiming for. I'll leave some of that in there. It's actually much more blue. Oh, a little crazy here. Brown that up a little bit more, or blue it up a little bit more as we go. I should purple it. That's a good color in there. So I want to back up in here. I was coming down out of this area. Now I want to come in here with that sloppiness, sloppy, sloppy, sloppy. It was down there. I wanted to run, 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 baby, run. Oops. Oops. Oops, he cried. And where are we going next? Okay, go down here. I cannot feel green or blue loose in your power. I want to take over everything. On some of these hard lines in here, just kind of, it's okay. Thank you. Just I'm getting a feel of those muscles nicely. All right, I think I'm gonna try that. I think I'm going to start my way here and move out. This is kind of a bluish purple I'm using. Oops, too much. Too much wrong. That's too much, too much. And I put mine with you. That's beautiful. I love this. The blue right there. That's beautiful. Love it. This is people in black. Just a touch of black in a few spots. I think I'm near to being done on the face. Just a little bit out of there. Lift a little bit out of that. Okay. All right, now that's neck is nice and strong color. Do you think this would be a simple painting because it's just the one figure, but everything takes time. The line right here, I'm actually going to get this. Bit more of that color in his cheek. And in here, in here. Now, you're going to need, it's starting to come together. I need a pink nose of the cell. I'm going to write just because. I'm going to erase this. I want to see what I've got with those lines all over the way. Okay, where are we? Not pay attention. I'm missing important lines. I have to drive back into it. On this side, it's dark. On this side, it's dark. There's a bit of a
now.
How are we doing on everything else?
Thank you.
Do I need to try it again? I don't know. Using some cerulean blue up in here. It's a nice color for certain things. It's a bit of an opaque color, so it's gotta be careful how I use it. Oops, too much. Too wide a stroke. Probably is sloppy. Okay, now I think I need to dry. Okay, so in here, there is definitely a well, the talking muscles. I'm gonna make sure I do them. I missed this one. Wait up here. It's too wet to do. So, insert says, a lot of people are scared to put the darks in, so afraid to ruin their painting, but he said if they don't put the darks in, they've already ruined their painting. These colors keep drying lighter than I think I'm putting them on, so I'm trying to just darken them up. I'm using a lot of info tens here. That's interesting. Colors always dry so much lighter than what you think they're going to be. Then you're disappointed. You know, I'm getting that working better. Extensive of those muscles. I like that. Maybe. Maybe not. Done. Anyway, there's how I painted the horse. I don't know if I demonstrated what I hope to very well, but the idea is I'm trying to get this musculature in here with the darks and the lights. And then I was trying to plan out where some of my lights and darks went. Anyhow, for what it's worth, there's my effort.